themselves writers, because that's what they do. They write their names, among other things, everywhere. Names they've been given or have chosen for themselves. Most of all, they write in and on subway trains, which carry their names from one end of the city to the other. It's called bombing. And it has equally assertive counterparts in rap music and breakdance. Graffiti writing in New York is a vocation. Its traditions are handed down from one youthful generation to the next. To some, it's art. To most people, however, it is a plague that never ends. A symbol that we've lost control.
Graffiti, as the name itself, is not an art. But I can sure as hell tell you that that's a crime.
At the Grand Concourse, 149th Street Station in the Bronx, graffiti writers gather at what they call the writer's bench.
The system is out of control, and the 15 and 16-year-old kids are running the system, and that graffiti is a symbol of that.
Nah, I ain't running the
system. Hell yeah.
I'm bombing the system.
What'd you do last night?
We did two whole cars. It was me, Dez, and me and Tree, right? And on the first car, in small letters, it said, all you see is, and then, you know, big, you know, black silver letters, it said, crime in the city.
The idea of style and competing for the best style is the key to all forms of rocking. For the rap MC, it's rocking the mic. For the B-boys, it's rocking the body and breakdancing. Or for writers, rocking the city with your name on a train.
It's a name. It's just like, I'll give you a name and you say, hey, how big did you get this name up?
It's called going all city. People see your tags in Queens, uptown, downtown, all over.
We're tagging with the Unis and the Minis and the Marvies and the Pilots and the Flow Pens. And we were doing clouds around the tags and 3Ds on the tags. We just had an orgasm.
I did a bomb theory, that's what I started for. I didn't start writing to go to Paris, I didn't start writing to do canvases. I started writing the bomb story online. That's what I'm doing.
In the 1970s, New York graffiti, rapping, and breaking became the prime expression in a new young people subculture called hip-hop.
Rage, origin, yo, you wanted to stand out, boom! The whole shit around the whole world, red origin, yo! Them houses in the womb, the poet all around the game, the man came on the fire.
Take my time, be creative.
When you talking on the phone, you don't doodle on the paper?
I don't doodle.
Yes, you do.
I do not
doodle. You do doodle on the paper.
I don't doodle.
I don't doodle. I just write my name while I'm talking on the phone. What's that? Colors, cards, staff.
All pop-pop. You got records.
Graffiti is the written word. It's the spoken word of rap music. And then there's the acrobatic body language of dances like breaking.
Break that.